the best of the rest of the news. According to a recent Reuters poll, 3/4 of Americans believe there is too much money in our politics, and 76% of Americans believe all the money that has given the rich far more influence in government than average Americans. Unfortunately, for all those Americans, we're on the verge of seeing far more money spent in this coming election than any other election in our nation's history. And we can thank the Supreme Court and its Citizens United decision for that. We can also thank the Republican Party, which just this week approved its official 2012 platform, which calls for even more unfettered corporate millionaire and billionaire spending in our elections. However, despite all of this, the movement to overturn Citizens United with a constitutional amendment just got a big boost from none other than the President of the United States. During an online question and answer forum on Reddit.com, President Obama was asked to do something about the corrupting influence of money in politics post-Citizens United. He responded by calling for the Disclose Act to be passed to at least add transparency to all the spending, and then he went further saying, over the longer term, I think we need to seriously consider mobilizing a constitutional amendment process to overturn Citizens United, assuming the Supreme Court doesn't revisit it. Even if the amendment process falls short, it can shine a light on the super PAC phenomenon and help apply pressure for change. So what effect, if any, will the president's support have on the movement to kick corporations and very, very wealthy people out of our democracy? For more on this, Mike Papantonio joins me now. He's an attorney and host of the Ring of Fire radio program. Mike, welcome back.
How are you?
I'm just great, and I hope you're well, too. The president has spoken out against Citizens United before, but this is the first time he's endorsed a constitutional amendment. Do you think he might be feeling the heat now that he's about to be the first incumbent president who's been outspent?
Well, he's certainly feeling the heat, but he's a constitutional law professor himself, Tom, and he understands that the chance of passing a constitutional amendment is slim to none. I mean, look, you've got the way it happens is you can pass it through Congress if you can get 2/3 of Congress, congressional majority, to say, yeah, we want to change the Constitution, or you can do it by a constitutional convention where you have 2/3 of the states in the United States say we want to change things. That is not easy to do. As a matter of fact, none of the 27 amendments to the Constitution, Tom, have taken place by way of a constitutional amendment. So a constitutional convention, excuse me.
Right.
So he's running against the wind
Absolutely, I don't disagree. I mean, there's been over 29,000 proposed constitutional amendments in Congress since the very first Congress, and we have a total of, 28 or 29 that have passed. But some of them, I mean, the amendment to undo prohibition, or more recently, the one to allow 18-year-olds to vote, that was proposed in Congress in March, and it was ratified by the states in either August or September of the same year. Because there was a national, in fact, I think that song, Eve of Destruction, you know, you're old enough to kill but not to vote. So I really think that song was what drove that constitutional amendment. And people are waking up and people are getting really pissed off. Isn't it possible that there could be a large enough movement that we could see something like that?
Well, I think President Obama may have been right about this, Tom. It's certainly something that would raise everybody's concern. I mean, at some point, you can put enough pressure on Congress by putting pressure on the people, by having the people so upset that they put pressure on Congress. That's the most likely way for this to take place. And when he said we can shine a light on the corruption that's taken place by way of political money, the $8 billion in super PACs that's going to go into this election, I think what he was trying to say is look, this is the best shot we can do is move it by moving the people. But the framers of the Constitution, Tom, and you know this, they create out of Article 5, that document, there was serious disagreement about whether how we ought to go about amending the Constitution. Mm-hmm. You had one part of the framers that said it should be a liberal, a fairly easy process. We should make it something where we shouldn't have to live in a government that was written by, it was framed by people who are now dead. It's a living document. And then, but the other side of it is what you call the originalist. And unfortunately, in America right now, the numbers show most people are afraid to do anything to the Constitution, certainly by way of constitutional convention. So it is a very long shot if you really consider what
I personally would be totally opposed to a constitutional convention, because that's like opening the whole thing up to tinker with in the middle of a time when billionaires and corporations are allowed to spend piles of money. But I could see a single constitutional amendment, possibly the one that moved to amend.org is proposing, for example. I'm actually a fan of that, but maybe I'm just, you know, one of those hopeful idealists. I'm curious your thoughts on what's going on at the RNC so far.
Well, the RNC at this point, they're having, it's almost every day they're having to put forward ideas that on their face we see that there's really no truth to it. I've never seen anybody get a beating as badly as Paul Ryan is getting today for what he represented in his speech last night. You know, there was a time when traditional media was so afraid to do fact-checking, so afraid to call people out. I think they've almost been shamed into it in this convention, that there's only so far you can push the truth, and at some point even mainstream media says we have to say something about it. When you see the reaction that's occurred with Paul Ryan, you get a sense of the fact that maybe mainstream media is buying into the idea that we have to ask tough questions of these politicians.
Yeah, I'm absolutely with you, Mike Papantonio. Thanks so much for being with us tonight.
Thank you.